morning and I greet you according to the time you're watching me in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, the author and the finisher of our faith. And I welcome you to a new year. And I pray that the year will be a fulfilling year for you. To be a year full of monumental blessing. Blessing in abundance in the mighty name of Jesus. Whatsoever you lay your hands upon in this new year shall prosper. Every closed door against you, I open it in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. And I want you to know that God is with us. God is with us in this new year. He will never leave us nor forsake us. And by the grace of God, the theme the Lord has given us this year is new glory. I hope I hear someone saying new glory. I wish to hear that. New glory. And the text of concentration throughout the whole year is the book of Haggai, chapter 2, verse 9. That said, the glory of the latter house shall be greater than the former, saith the Lord of hosts. And he said, he will give us peace. He will give us peace in this place, saith the Lord of hosts. I hope you're claiming that word to yourself. I wish you're claiming that word to yourself. I want you to know the glory of the latter house. The Lord said it shall be greater than the former. And this is what has given us the audacity, that the Lord will glorify us. He will crown us with a new glory in this year 2022. No matter what it takes, no matter what it takes, please, I want you to sharpen your sensitivity, your spiritual life, and your discernment. And how can this happen? You need to revisit your secret place, the place where you talk to your God. Many times prophecy comes. Many times watch word for the year come, and it comes and go in the life of people without fulfilling it, without coming to pass in their life. This is very wrong. Can I hear someone say error? It is an error. So please, I want to urge us. This year 2022, if you want everything to go smoothly, pray. Let me write. I say pray. You need to pray through the journey of this year 2022. Prayer is the key for the journey of the year 2022. I mean what I'm saying. If there is a man that can pray, I tell you there is God in heaven that can answer prayer. It's very, very important. Be spiritual in this year. Because the Bible made us to understand that to be carnally minded is death. To be carnally minded is death. But to be spiritually minded is life and peace. Please be spiritual this year. All those things you might have done in the year 2021, 2020, or the year back, please, I want you to drop it. And mend a business with God this year. Mean serious business with God this year. No wonder the Bible also says, if the people that are called by my name shall humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn away from their wickedness, then will I hear from heaven. I will forgive them their sin and I will heal their land. This is the direct word of the Lord. And if me and you can humble ourselves and seek the face of the Lord in this year, I tell you, and I'm sure of what I'm saying, the Lord is ready to perfect that which concerns us. And that is how the new glory can manifest in our life. Please let us be spiritually minded in this year. Life in itself is spiritual. And anyone that to walk in this life and succeed must be spiritually minded. I tell you, if you want to succeed in life, you must be spiritual. You must be spiritual, I tell you. I mean it. Please, this year, there is so much on our table this year to consider about new glory. You will understand what is the meaning of glory. What glory entails. How can glory affect you positively and negatively? So many. Can glory die? Can glory be revived? What is the glory of God? So many things. All these are what we are going to consider in this year. But one of the things that trigger me is that many people doesn't pay attention to what glory really entails, what glory can do to you. But I promise you, I give you my word, throughout this year, I pray that the Lord will open our eyes to see the depths in this word glory. And He has given us this word. He said new glory. If the Lord is saying the glory of the latter house shall be greater than the former, that means me and you, we have an assurance from the Most High God, and He's ready to perfect that which concerns us. I say, please and please, I beg us, try as much as possible to move closer to your Maker this year. Nothing can help you. A prophet cannot help you. A pastor cannot help you. Apostle cannot help you. Nobody can help you except your Maker, the one which was, which is, and which is to come. The Alpha, the Omega, He's the one that can help you. Your parents cannot help you. No one can help you except God. If any man help you today, they will definitely talk about it tomorrow. But it is God that is a covenant-keeping God. He's the one that favors man and never asks for a collateral. Please, I want you to hold on to God this year. God have many things in stock for us. But you need to do what? You need to seek Him. He says, seek me while I may be found. Seek me while I may be found. This is the word of the Lord. Me and you, we are far away from the will of God. We are far away from the plan of God. And it made us to understand that all His plans for us are good, that are not evil, that He may give us a happy ending. So why are we suffering as a slave in the palace of our Father? Why? It's because we are not paying attention. Please, I urge us. I want us to pay attention this year. So many things are in store for us. And I promise you, I will not disappoint you. The Lord has not been disappointing you. He will not disappoint you. And sister, this is just a call. This is a call from a loving heart. Please, let's make it right. If you notice, 5 days has already passed from this year. 5 days just walk majestically out of this year. Before you know it, we'll be counting 5 days to 2023. Sorry. We'll be counting just 5 days to 2023. And by that time, what will you see? Will you be thanking God that, God, I thank you, I achieved something significant by moving closer to you and you crowning me with a new glory? Will you be able to say that? At the 5 days to 2023, will you be able to say this word? That God, I thank you that I know you more, that I walk with you through 2022. Come and do the same in the year 2023. Will I and you be able to pray the same prayer 5 days to 2023? And I pray that the grace and what will happen in our life, that we will be able to pray this prayer, the Lord will make it happen in the name of Jesus. Please and please, my brethren, let us make it right with our Maker. God love me and you. I don't need to start telling us. If you look closely what is happening around you, 3, 4, 5 years back, it is not what you plan at the beginning of the year that you see at the end of the year. And have you sat down and asked yourself that what is really happening? And to God be the glory, God is giving us a word this year. New glory. That means things must change. Power must change hand. And for that power to change hand, me and you, we needed to do what? We needed to move closer to God. We needed to know God the more. We needed to make him our driver, the driver of our life. That is the only way. That is the only way. Have you ever seen the life that God is controlling that is in danger? No, I pray that our life will never be in danger in the name of Jesus. Remain blessed. God bless you, and I say to your life that your glory will shine. Your glory will shine. Your glory, I said, it will shine beyond your limitation. Beyond your limitation, the Lord will announce you with a new glory. The hand of the Lord will rest upon your life. As from this day, anything you lay your hands upon shall prosper. The passion and the love for the things of God, the Lord will rest it upon your life in the name of Jesus. Genuine hunger and thirsty for the things of God, the Lord will bestow it upon your life in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray for you once again. I said the love for God, the love for the things of God, the Lord will release it upon your life in the mighty name of Jesus. The grace to do the will of the Lord in this year 2022, the Lord will release it upon your life in the mighty name of Jesus. So shall it be in Jesus' name. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. We return all the glory back to the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, the Ancient of Days, the I Am that I Am, that has always been on our side. And don't forget to subscribe to this YouTube channel. And our meeting time is usually on our TikTok platform at Ewa Onyade 1. Ewa Onyade, try and join us every Tuesday, Thursday and Saturday, 6 p.m. Every Tuesday, Thursday and Saturday is our meeting time. We spend just 2 hours. By the grace of God, that is the schedule for this year. Tuesday, Thursday and Saturday, 6 p.m. Just 2 hours. And the Lord will perfect that which concerns you. Please don't miss out. Don't miss out. So many things will be revealed. You will see so many things. So many things will be revealed to you. So come expectant. Be ready for God this year. And God will do yours. God will perfect that which concerns you. In the mighty name of Jesus. You will not fail. Where others are failing, the Lord will lift you high. I said, where others are crying, the Lord will put a smile on your face in Jesus' name. So shall it be. I love you and I celebrate you all.